The marketing for Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker by Disney and Lucasfilm is all set and ready to begin tonight on Monday Night Football during, of course, halftime on ESPN starting at 8:15 Eastern Standard Time. Some point in time, the halftime will begin around 10 to 10:15, give or take, and a lot of fans are very excited about the third and final trailer of this movie. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future Star Wars content. Now, we do know that Disney and Lucasfilm are really trying their very best in order to promote this film in a very specific and unique way, in order to really sell it to the fans and to really encourage them in order to go ahead and see this movie in theaters on December 19th of this year, which is when it officially releases. And a lot of fans are very concerned on whether or not Disney and Lucasfilm really know what they're doing, with, of course, the reshoots that are still taking place as we speak. Now, beyond all of this, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this film, and specifically about the upcoming trailer. And what's really intriguing and rather unfortunate at the same exact time has all to do with this. Now, specifically, what's really interesting about this is that it's ascribed that Disney and Lucasfilm are currently ready to release the official final trailer of the film tonight during Monday Night Football, during the Jets game that will take place on ESPN. It's explained that, however, Disney has made multiple changes to the upcoming footage some days ago that is rather unfortunate, where one of the big changes to the upcoming release of the trailer is that Disney cut many of the prequel trilogy themes that would be demonstrated for the upcoming trailer, one of which was said to be Across the Stars theme that would have played midway through the trailer during a space battle segment, where it's said that Disney is saving this revised track by John Williams for a major TV spot in early November. Additionally, it said that Disney and Lucasfilm diminished many of the Luke Skywalker visuals for the upcoming trailer, and that though there are shots of Luke, most of which will be very brief and fast now, and that they are focusing more on dialogue of Luke for the final trailer. Now, this too was also to save footage for the major TV spot in early November. Another adjustment by Disney involved many of the scenes that were directed by George Lucas for the film to be put to the wayside and to be canceled out of the trailer to save for a later date in November for a special TV spot as well in late November that is described to have a key shot for the movie. The new trailer originally was also to have an appearance on Tatooine that would bring fans back to the original trilogy, however, that too was also cut to make way for other surprises related to the dark side and Palpatine. Lastly, it's explained that Disney has removed a scene featuring a de-aged Carrie Fisher as Leia in order to save the surprise at a later date in November once again. Many of these adjustments were due to reshoots and Disney figuring out exactly how certain scenes would flow in the film. So, let's go over a couple of parts about this. Now, obviously, this is a downer for the upcoming footage of Episode 9, without a doubt. A lot of people love Luke, a lot of people love Leia, and not to mention that a lot of people love George Lucas. Now, keep in mind that a lot of this stuff is just being shifted over to a later date for a major TV spot in early November and late November. You guys may recall that for The Last Jedi during the World Series game, I believe it was for... If I'm not mistaken, it might have been for the fifth game, if I'm not mistaken here, but back in 2017 during the World Series, we got a major TV spot that was basically a fourth trailer. It was very long. There was a lot of footage in there. In fact, it's the TV spot in which we saw Rey lifting the Skywalker saber toward Luke on the ground. Now, with that being said, all right, we do know that Disney and Lucasfilm are going through a lot of things right now in order to get this movie done correctly. A lot of reshoots took place in, of course, September, August, and, of course, during this month of October, where many of the Palpatine scenes were shifted, Leia and Luke scenes were changed here and there, not necessarily deleted, but changed, if you will, in order to really fit the narrative in a different way. Now, the one piece that I think really kind of just upsets me the most out of all of this is that a lot of the scenes that were directed and pretty much written by George Lucas for The Rise of Skywalker will now not be demonstrated in the upcoming footage of Episode 9's official Trailer 3 that is all set and ready to debut later tonight. So that's one to keep in mind here, is that they're also saving that for a later date in November, so it's not like that they're going to keep it out of their marketing entirely. It's just that for this particular trailer in and on itself, is that there will be no sequences that were directed by George Lucas or anything related in that sense. Now, the other thing that also is very much, you know, pretty upsetting to me as well is the fact that they got rid of many of the prequel trilogy themes. One of the major ones was, of course, Across the Stars, a revised track of Across the Stars by John Williams that would have played actually midway through the trailer during a major space battle segment. So that, too, was also put to the wayside and being saved for the major TV spots to come in November, specifically in the first and last week of November. So keep an eye open for that. That's going to be a very interesting time for sure. So on top of all this, guys, let me know what you think about this below in the comments, everything related to the upcoming trailer release of this movie. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.